Hey, measuring hero Josh here. Thanks for joining us for another episode. What we're going to do is actually speak to one of our experts. That's why I'm bringing my coffee with me here to make sure he has something before we get started. And we're going to go ahead and take a look at some new features for the upcoming release of PiWeb 8.2. And my special guest today, Jay, thanks for joining us.
Oh, Josh, thanks for having me. Appreciate it. Thanks for the coffee, man.
Absolutely.
Glad you did that. Okay, I have a question for you.
Absolutely.
Last time we spoke, we kind of went over some of the cool reporting functions for PiWeb, but I was wondering, are we doing anything to do data visualization for someone that maybe isn't a metrologist or something, you know, meant for the shop floor, someone that really doesn't know what they're looking at? Is there something that for them to make some decisions?
You know what, Jay, I think we spent a lot of time this past release putting a lot of effort and thought into how we can better bring results to that person on the shop floor. Mm-hmm. We worked with a few customers directly here in Germany to look at some situations where they wanted to look at the quality data directly on the machining center. Oh. So what we've done is we looked at kind of an end-to-end workflow. How are they looking at data? What do they are using basically for communication inside of the company? And what we've done is we've added two different feature sets, one working with balloon drawing or stamped drawings, depending on which terminology you use. And what we found out is that a lot of customers that are working directly on the shop floor, they're very familiar and used to working with basically the prints still. Mm-hmm. And what we've done is introduce an entire feature set to better work with these prints and then integrate them into PiWeb. And I've just created a quick example here of an example where on the shop floor, the operator who might not be too familiar with the whole quality world can then have a kind of a dashboard. And then if we take a look at this report, then click through the various characteristics. And then we see on the right-hand side, directly in the print, which characteristic might need attention. So this is a very interesting feature that makes it very easy for the person on the shop floor to interpret quality data and to see the results then directly in PiWeb Monitor. What we've also done is added another feature set, and this has to do with integrating barcodes and QR codes directly into reports as well. We can take a look at that too.
Yeah, that'd be great to see, because I think what I'm seeing here is we're really making a presentation of the data to something that someone on the shop floor would be more natural for them, right? They're used to the drawing. They may not be used to a report. They may not know how to make it make the connection, but we've given them the ability to just click through data and understand in a method that they are comfortable with, right?
Exactly, and there's a whole feature set around this. So if we take a look at, for example, PiWeb Planner, we can import these prints directly from the native ballooning software. Uh-huh. So customers typically already have one in-house, and they'll already have these stamped drawings or balloon drawings. They can export them in a neutral format, and then we can import them in the PiWeb if they need to be modified still. For example, the balloon position can be changed, or definitions can be changed, tolerances, etc. Then once it's defined in the system, then all of these native tools for the end user results in a very easy to use report that's interactive inside a monitor.
Great. So not only is it natural for them, but it's easy to set up.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Sweet. Of course, that's what you guys do, right?
Yeah, that's the goal. Exactly.
Okay, so I think I understand how the presentation will work and how it connects in with our data set, but what, and I think you've alluded to it, but what, do we have any tools that might be helpful that someone that is not skilled can take action if they see something?
Absolutely. So I kind of exactly alluded to it a little bit earlier and also prepared, of course, an example report for it. So we're just taking a look at a very typical PiWeb report with some run diagrams with the last measurements. We see some quality traffic lights with some obvious characteristics that are out of tolerance. And the question is, okay, what do I do with this data afterwards? Mm-hmm. How can I maybe transport this information from one system into another, whichever system that might be? It might just be giving this information and giving it to somebody that needs to act on it. So what we've done in the next release of PiWeb 8.2 is we've added a new feature that allows users to create their own variety of different QR codes, barcodes, data matrix codes, and to, how the customer wants to use that, they're really limited by their imagination. Mm-hmm. So these QR codes, barcodes, and data matrix codes can then be generated on the fly to contain whatever information the user wants. For the example we have here is if I go with or use my iPhone just to capture the QR code, mm-hmm. this will actually generate an email.
Oh.
And then with the information packed into the email saying, mm-hmm. you know, whichever colleague that needs to take action, that can also be defined variably with the characteristics that are out of tolerance, mm-hmm. and then that will generate an email for me and I can send it.
Yep.
And some other applications, of course, in like controlled manufacturing where there's barcodes involved, sometimes the user just needs to put the barcode of the particular part mm-hmm. on a report, and that can be automatically generated as well, saved as a PDF or then scanned into another system as
right,
well.
Right.
So just like you said, another tool in the toolbox to help our PiWeb users out to make the reports that they need and make
sure.
Meaningful reports.
And take action because they may not know what to do. They may just see something, email something, sound a siren, stop the line.
Exactly.
Whatever needs to happen. If they see some data, this QR code is definitely a tool to help them execute that.
Absolutely.
Well, Josh, it sounds like we're making it easier and easier for to utilize the quality data even for the non-skilled people. So.
Absolutely. It's 8.2 is going to be an exciting release. We have a ton of features. So of course, check out the information we have online about the new features that we have in the software. We always put kind of summary and overview of the feature highlights in our mm-hmm. landing page. So feel free to check it out if you want to learn more.
Absolutely, man. Well, it sounds great. Josh, thanks for having me. I appreciate it.
Absolutely. Anytime,
always,
Jay.
Always good to see you, and we'll see you soon.
Absolutely.
Cool, man. And for you out there, don't forget to stay safe, stay healthy, and see you next Thursday.